So we know from science that addiction is a chronic condition, similar to other chronic conditions like diabetes, asthma, and hypertension. And what that means is that all of these chronic conditions really require a long-term focus for treatment, where you have individuals who may need multi-pronged interventions. They may benefit from medication as well as behavioral interventions, and they may need multiple courses of treatment over time. It's not like strep throat, where I give you a prescription for an antibiotic, you take the antibiotic, and then you're cured. That is an acute disease, where one time you go in, you get your medication, you take it, and you don't continue to have strep throat any longer. Addiction is much different than that, and similar to other chronic conditions, it becomes important to be able to provide treatment over time, to be able to engage and monitor the individual over time, so that if they become at risk to relapse, so that you can intervene early, either to prevent the relapse or to re-engage them in treatment as soon as they relapse. And so that the individual begins to learn more themselves about how to be active in their recovery and how to begin to manage their disorder, in the same way my grandmother had to learn how to manage her diabetes. First of all, let me say that our specialty care drug abuse treatment system is still trying to kind of come to grips with how to deal with addiction as a chronic condition. So I don't think that this is something that's unique just to criminal justice. I think one of the classic examples, though, where criminal justice has the opportunity to make a change is that if someone participates in an intensive type of treatment program while they're incarcerated, often they participate in that treatment program and then they're deemed to be done with treatment and then they transition into the community and they go home. But what we know from our research is that those who are most successful in making that transition and in not relapsing to drug abuse have a more chronic approach where they participate in treatment while they're incarcerated and then they're followed up in the community and continue participating in additional treatment when they transition back out into the community.